Ciao friends, I want to show how to debug a DAX measure. In this Power BI report, I have a margin percentage that is wrong. My boss called me and said, Marco, this number is too large, the margin should be 53% or something like that. So I had to understand what is going on. Of course, I could open the definition of the measure and I could start to investigate here in Power BI, but a more productive way to do this job is to use DAX Studio. And in order to DAX Studio, I have to first capture the query generated by this visual. How can I do that? I can use the Performance Analyzer pane. I can start the recording and I can refresh the visuals. This way, when I click here, all the visuals are refreshed and I can capture the query of the visual that contains the wrong measure. Now that I copied the query, I can go to DAX Studio and I can connect DAX Studio to my model. Now I open DAX Studio and I connect DAX Studio to my local instance of Power BI Desktop and I paste the code here. This is the same code generated by Power BI to retrieve the data displayed in the report. I can execute this code here using run and I can see here the result in DAX Studio. So far I just have the same information, but now I have an environment that makes it easier to investigate on what is going on. For example, here the first thing I want to do, I want to see the definition of the measure margin percentage that I'm using here. So I can go here in the metadata pane, I can search for margin and I see, okay, I have margin percentage measure. When I right click here, you see that I have a menu that I can use to define a local definition of the measure in my DAX query. When I click here, the code changes and include the definition of the measure margin percentage, copying the definition that we have in Power BI here. Now, the difference is that if I run this query again, I see the same result, but now I can apply changes to this definition. So for example, if I write here, multiply by 1000, you see that my expression reflects here. So the DAX query uses the local definition of the measure instead of the measure defined in Power BI. So the data is in Power BI, but I'm overriding the existing measure with the local measure defined here. This is quite interesting, but actually, looking at this code, I see that I have other two measures used in this measure. I'm referencing the margin and the sales amount measures. So, okay, I have margin here, I can right-click and I can include the margin in the query, and I can repeat the same process for total cost, for sales amount. Now, sometimes you have tens of measures involved in a single calculation. This could be boring. So, a more efficient way to retrieve a measure with all the measures that are included in the execution path is to use another feature we have here. When I right-click, I can use Define Dependent Measure, which means that I include not only margin percentage, but all the measures used by this measure and the other measure. So down the path, we include all the measures that are involved in the calculation. You see that we also have the total cost, which is referenced by margin, but was not referenced initially by margin percentage. At this point, it's up to you to evaluate the code and find the problem. For example, here, looking at the code in a single page, it's easier to me to detect that actually the sales amount is a too large value because I'm using the unit price, which is a price that includes an amount that the customer didn't pay, the discount. So there is another column called net price, which actually contains the actual amount of money paid by the customer, not the list price, but actually the net price, so the list price minus the discount. Indeed, if I run the query now, so I changed this definition of sales amount locally to this DAX query, and this definition is used in the other local measures of the query. This is not affecting the other measures that we have in Power BI, but everything is included here in this query is overriding the measure defined in Power BI. So now, if I execute the query, you see that the numbers now are different. Now the total here is 53%. And so I found where my problem was and I can copy the definition of sales amount in the clipboard. I go back to Contoso, I click on sales amount and I fix the sales amount measure. Of course, because now I fix the sales amount measure, Oops, sorry. Something went wrong here. So let me close the performance analyzer so I have enough space here. I paste the code. I have now the net price. I confirm. And you see that my new number here is now 53%. We have seen how to debug a DAX measure using Power BI and DAX Studio. Enjoy!